Let's review Math, Grade 4, Module 5, Lesson 34, Fraction Equivalents, Ordering, and Operations. Topic F, Addition and Subtraction of Fractions by Decomposition. Okay, so in this example, we have 8 and 1 tenth minus 8 tenths. So right away I can see that I don't have enough tenths to subtract 8 tenths. I'm going to use a number bond to break this up so that I can subtract my 8 tenths. So what I'll do is I'm going to think about 8 and 1 tenth as a number bond of 7 and 11 tenths. And here's why that works. 7 plus 1 is 8. 10 tenths is equal to 1. So 7 plus 10 tenths plus this 1 tenth would be 7 and 11 tenths. Now I can subtract 7 and 11 tenths minus 8 tenths equals 7 and 3 tenths. Let's show this on a number line just to make sure we understand it. So here's my number line. It's got a 7, an 8, and a 9 on it. And what I want to do is I want to show where 7 and 11 tenths is located. So I'm going to have to separate the space between the 7 and the 8 into 10 parts. And I'm going to have to separate the space between the 8 and the 9 into 10 parts. Now I can find where 8 and 1 tenth would be. 8 and 1 tenth would be the same as saying 7 and 10, 11 tenths. It would be here. Now, I just need to subtract 8 tenths from that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 tenths. So I'm subtracting 8 tenths. So wherever this is on the number line will be the difference between 8 and 1 tenth and 8 tenths. So I go 7 and 1 tenth, 2 tenths, 3 tenths. So this position is 7 and 3 tenths. Just like our answer here. Okay, let's take a look at this one. I have 4 and 1 fifth minus 2 and 4 fifths. So let's try this one using the arrow way. I'm going to begin with 4 and 1 fifth. And then the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to subtract my two wholes. So that would be 4 and 1 fifth minus 2. And I'm going to take the 2 from the 4. So that would mean I would have 2 and 1 fifth left over. Now, I've taken away the 2. Now I need to subtract the 4 fifths. When I subtract the 4 fifths, what I do is I think about this 2 as being broken into a number bond. So now, I have 1 here and 1 here. Well, I can take this 1 and I can change it into 5 fifths because 5 fifths is equal to 1 1. And then I can subtract 4 fifths. When I do, it'll leave me with 1 fifth. So I take that 1 fifth and this 1 fifth and it would leave me with 1 and 2 fifths. And that'll take care of things for lesson 34, where we've been subtracting mixed numbers.